YouTubers with franchise guy coming at you again with a brand set of our MLB The Show 20 Phillies franchise mode. The 27 and 14 Phillies are taking on the Aaron Judge and Jorge Soler led Los Angeles Dodgers. Now, can you imagine that team if they kept on to Cody Bellinger? It would be insane. But Luis Severino, 31 for Philadelphia, 8 games, he's 5-1, 241 ERA, 3 innings pitched, 46 hits, a 109 whip, 11 walks, 265 strikeouts. We'll see, so not a bad start to this season at all for Luis Severino. But taking on Bradley Zimmer goes down for the first out right there on that strikeout, first of the game for Severino. Now Gavin Lux up, 3-2 count. Lux will swing at what could have been ball four for the second out here, and the second punch out of the game for Severino. Now Aaron Judge up. Aaron Judge, his big body sub, gets behind that one, sends that one deep to left field, and that one is gone. That's going to be the 10th home run on the season for Aaron Judge. You hate to see that right there if you're a Phillies fan. But Luis Severino, who doesn't get taken deep often, gets taken deep right there by the former teammate, former Yankee superstar, former Yankee face. I don't know how I want to say what he is. But Jorge Soler up, and Soler gets a hold of that one. Former Phillies pinch hitter takes that one deep to left or right center field and puts that one in the bullpen for a solo shot. 14th on the year for Soler, getting a shot in the National League. I feel like he'd be more of an American League DH type. But if they're going to disregard that defense for his bat, good on the Los Angeles Dodgers for weighing that out right there. Now Ryan O'Hearn up, playing first base for the Dodgers. Chops that one in front of the plate. JT gets it quickly and will fire the first base in time for the out. So, inning finally over after two home runs as Dustin May takes the mound for the Dodgers. In 8 games, he's 5-0, 2.15 ERA, 54 innings pitched, 43 hits allowed, 110. This is whip, 17 walks, 246 strikeouts. So May, not a huge strikeout guy, opposed to Luis Severino, but he can rack him up. Austin Meadows leading off, and Meadows puts that one into play right there, off the right field wall. But it was hit pretty hard on the line, so only a single to the outfield for the Phillies left fielder. JT up now, and JT puts that one on the ground. Past the outstretched glove of the shortstop. So a man on first and second now for Bryce Harper, who puts that one on the ground. Gavin Lux spins, bad throw. Runner is taken off, the fielder is taken off the bag for Reese Hoskins, who puts that one on the ground past the shortstop. Doesn't even make a dive for it. Two runs will score on that single right there, and the Phillies have tied it up here in the first with nobody out. Alec Bohm puts down on the ground. Chopper past the shortstop. Harper on his way home will score with ease. And the Phillies take a 3-2 lead with no one out here in the first inning. Adam Haseley up. Haseley gets a hold of that low fastball, drives that one to right field, and that one's off the face of the wall. Haseley's around first, staying at second. Runner from first going home. And Alec Bohm gets tagged out at the plate that time, thanks to a good throw. He's definitely out. Now Scott Kingery grounds out to the shortstop for the second out here. Bryson Stott up, and Stott gets that hanging changeup, sends that one to the left center field, so that's a center field for the final out here in the first inning. So Phillies rattle off a bunch of hits, score four runs, take a 2-0 lead, a 2-4-2 lead here in the first. Now, Severino starting off the second with a strikeout, his third of the game. Hubert Ruiz up, takes that one to right field. That one's going to go off the top of the wall right there. Harper tries to make a jump for it. Cannot. He's not that tall. Haseley, though, cuts it off. And that's going to be a one-out double. Will Smith up. Smith, the shortstop, second base, catcher hybrid he is, goes down for the fourth punch of the game for Severino. And Dustin May puts that one in play to right field. Harper with the slow trot makes the catch for the final out here. No runs on one hit as the Phillies still lead 4-2. Severino leading off the second inning for the Phillies. Puts down on the ground, scooped up by the shortstop. Over to first base in time with that pick thanks to Ryan O'Hearn for the first out in the second inning. As the Phillies are looking to add more runs to that amazing first inning they had where they scored four runs. Now Austin Meadows up. Meadows takes that middle outside fastball to deep right field. Judge with the catch though for the second out here in the second inning. So May at 30 pitches so far. Not quite a lot, but also he's not cruising per se. JT tees up that hanging curveball, sends that one to deep center field. Center field at the wall and will make the catch. Warning track power as JT just misses a home run. Bradley Zimmer up again, and Zimmer goes down the same way he went down the first inning with a strikeout. Five of the day now for Luis Severino. As you see, he's tied with Mick Abel and a bunch of other people for second in the league in wins. Alex Young right there leads all with six. Now Gavin Lux up, and Lux goes down on the changeup. So back-to-back punch outs yet again. Same as a couple innings ago. Aaron Judge up now, 3-2 count, and Judge puts that one on the ground. Boom. With it, double clutches, fires the first base in time. So no home run this time by Aaron Judge as Alec Boehm makes the good defensive play. Bryce Harper up now, and Harper tees off on that middle fastball, and that one goes to deep right field off of the right field scoreboard for his 16th home run on the season. So if you thought Jorge Soler with 14 was a lot, just say, hey, Bryce Harper has 16 of his own home runs coming into this series. Or coming, I guess, now 16 home runs. He's got a lot of home runs early on in the year. It's definitely a home run race between those two players. And who's going to end the season with more home runs? But see that right there. Goes off of Reese Hoskins' name on the scoreboard. No doubt shot right there. Dustin May knew it was gone. Reese Hoskins up, had a single and two RBIs in the first, and takes that middle fastball to deep left field. So back-to-back jacks for the Phillies. As Philadelphia takes a 6-2 lead over the Los Angeles Dodgers. 13th on the season for Hoskins. 434 feet. 106.7 off the bat right there. That's just a no-doubt shot by the Phillies first baseman. As there's definitely been some up and down on how much the fans like Reese Hoskins. You know, some fans love him, some fans hate him. It's really weird. Alec Boehm up, and Alec Boehm takes that low curveball. Puts that in the right field for a no-out single. Adam Haseley up now, and Haseley connects that one, puts that one in play. That's going to get past Aaron Judge. Doesn't run all that well, but a no-out double following those two home runs and a single. Scott Kingery up, and Scott Kingery mercifully goes down looking right there at that fastball on that outside half of the plate. Bryson Stott up now, and Stott. Low curveball, left field. Jorge Soler's arm being tested. And offline to the cutoff man. And Alec Boehm will score with ease. Look at him get that hand on the plate like an absolute pro. Dodgers manager, Dodgers pitching coach, someone for the Dodgers comes out now and says, hey, Dustin, you had yourself a rough day. You're going to get the loss probably. Your perfect season's over. You're not going to go 5-0. You're not going to go 30-0. Whatever he's trying to go. So he's pulled from the game now. And in will come Tyler Carpenter. Carpenter in six games, win 2-0. 5 2/3 innings pitched. A 12.71 ERA. All right. 7-5 for the strikeouts to walks. Righty's batting 500. Lefty's batting 368. So a very weird hodgepodge of stats for Mr. Carpenter. As Luis Severino sends that one to right field. Caught by the right fielder. Hate to see that. But Severino working with a 5-run lead. Strikes out Jorge Soler, who went deep in his first at-bat. I'd love to see adjustments made by Severino. Ryan O'Hearn up now, and O'Hearn puts that one on the ground. Under the glove of Reese Hoskins, though, but Kingery with the heads-up play. Gets it from the outfield, Severino covering. Gets the second out right there. Ryan O'Hearn cannot believe what had just happened right there. But a bang-bang play by the Phillies on defense. Connor Joe up, and Joe grounds out to the first baseman, Reese Hoskins, who can easily make the play this time. You love to see that. So Phillies don't allow any hits, only one strikeout, and a couple ground outs to end the top of the fourth. On the fourth, let off by Austin Meadows, and Meadows takes that inside changeup to right field, center field. Caught by the center fielder right there with ease. JT up now, 2-1 count, and JT connects with that one. Perfect. That's middle almost. It's pretty much down the plate. Ninth home run of the season for the Phillies catcher right there. You'll love to see that. One behind Aaron Judge. Absolutely wild to think you're one home run behind Aaron Judge as a catcher. But foot on home plate right there. You'll love to see that by JT. Good home run, good score right there. Good home run trot, good home run swing. Look at that, James McCann back in that Phillies uniform, high-fiving his battery mate. Hey, that's the price you pay with that replay right there. JT just muscles that one over that left field wall. For some reason, I feel like I'm, I don't know why I'm calling all the fields the wrong fields, but I am. Bryce Harper up now, and Harper puts that one on the ground. Shortstop with the play and will make the throw in time for the second out here in the fourth inning. So Harper is retired, unfortunately, which will lead to Reese Hoskins, who homered earlier in the game. And Hoskins puts down on the ground for a two-out single to left field. Love to see that right there. Alec Bohm's up, and Bohm very late on that fastball for the final out on the strikeout. Now Severino taking on Ruiz, and Ruiz goes down swing on that inside slider. And a real good old wrist breaker right there, eighth of the game. Will Smith up, and Smith called strike three. Nine strikeouts on the game for Luis Severino. As he is cruising through this Dodgers lineup after that very rough first inning. But a pinch hitter right here for the Dodgers as Matt Beattie comes in, and Beattie goes down to that fastball. So, striking out the side in order as Matt Beattie ends off the inning. I'm confused with Matt Batty of the New York Mets. Matt Andreese comes in 19 games. He's 0-3, 19 innings pitched, a 4.19 ERA, 25-7 in strikeouts to walk. So, not a great season to start with for Matt Andreese. But Matt will get Adam Haseley. I'm confusing my hitters now. It's Adam Haseley to fly out to center field. Now Scott Kingery up. 1-2 count. Kingery swings that low curveball right there. Possibly could have been ball two. But we'll never know as this is his first strikeout of the game. Bryson Stott up now, and Stott connects with that one. That one's going to go to right field, caught by Aaron Judge. Not sure what the problem is with me today, but I don't know what my fields are. I don't know what anything is. Ground ball to second base and Scott Kingery. Kingery goes at first base as he throws there in time for the first out. You like to see that right there. Now Gavin Lux up, 1-2 count. And Lux seems like a very weird delayed swing. But 11 punch-outs on the game right now for Severino. And Aaron Judge up. And Judge will pop that one up to Luis Severino in front of home, in front of the pitcher's mound, which is also in front of home plate. Gets the final out. Bottom of the sixth, led off by Severino, who will get himself a base hit to right field. So he's going to end the inning with his glove and start off with his bat. But cruising right now. As Austin Meadows comes up, this time he's going to ground himself into a double play. Throw pulls the first baseman off the bag right there. So Meadows saved by the poor throw by the return throw. That ball goes behind the catcher. And guess what? Meadows moves up to second base right there. That's what you call a wild pitch right there. And he's safe. He touched the bag. JT up now. And JT goes down swinging at that high fastball. So, second out of the inning now. as Harper puts down on the ground. Changeup's pretty low, and it eats up the shortstop. JT not stopping and scoring. I'm sorry, Austin Meadows not stopping and scoring. Reese Hoskins up now, puts that one on the ground. Shortstop's got it. Over to first base in time for the out. But the Phillies do score a run on a heads-up play by Austin Meadows. Tyler Zuber in to make his Major League debut in relief of Luis Severino, the 5'11 righty. With 29 years old, he's making his debut. Yes, 97 on the gun right there for his first Major League strikeout. First batter he sees, first strikeout he gets. You'll love to see that. So Zuber, who was with the Royals, got traded over here for Mickey Moniak. Now found that first strikeout with a strikeout of Ryan O'Hearn. So back-to-back punch-outs for Phillies relief pitcher and Connor Joe. Puts that one into play, right field. Harper plays off the wall pretty easily. Kingery gets in to the cutoff man, gets into the shortstop. But a two-out double. And Kiba Ruiz up, and Ruiz gets a hold of that one. Wrong Ruiz right here. You're going to get no chooch calls this time. And that's going to be a home run right there. You hate to see that. You really do. Tyler Zuber, though, allowing his first home run as a big leaguer. Sixth of the season for Kiba Ruiz as the Dodgers cut their lead to by two on that home run right there. So you hate to see a two-run home run with two out in the inning. But following that up with a Will Smith strikeout. So strikeout side, but it's not in order. Vince Velasquez, former Phillies starter relief pitcher, headache. Andy comes in for his 26th game, but so far this season he's 1-0 there. He's pitched a 2.35 ERA, 31 strikeouts, only 9 walks. Alec Boehm makes that 10 walks. Leadoff walk for Vince Velasquez, and that's how you get in his head. He's got that confidence factor. It's either he's lights out, or one thing doesn't go his way, and he is lights off. Swing and a miss. Adam Haseley striking out right there. Kind of a little iffy right there if he's going to be, what he's going to do next. Scott Kingery gets a single to the left, two to the right, throwing a 3-1 count. So better than a walk, I'd like to think, but not what Velasquez wants. Now Bryson Stott pops that one up behind the plate. Will Smith through Ruiz with the catch for the second out in the seventh inning. Gonna be, I'm not sure who's behind the catch right there. But Randy Rosarena pinch hitting for Tyler Zuber. We're not gonna send the relief pitcher for his first major league at bat quite yet. But batting 189, he's gonna get himself a base hit right there. One run will score. No, they're gonna go back to third base due to how fast the center fielder got there. And Austin Meadows bails out his former teammate. Not even sure Austin Meadows played with Vince Velasquez, but bailed out former Phillies headache Vince Velasquez as Mick Abel. Current Phillies headache in 16 games is 5-0. One blown save. He's not bad. He's got a sub-2 ERA. But gets a big strikeout right there to start off this 8th inning. Now, Bradley Zimmer up. Zimmer will. Tee off on that one, so the home run ball still a problem behind Mick Abel. As Zimmer gets his 10th home run on the season. You hate to see that if you're a Phillies fan, you really do. Not what you want at all from your relief pitcher. That starter relief pitcher, you know, you kind of want to transition him to be a starter, but you need to get him in some work in the major league. You can't just keep him in the minor leagues all the time. Now, Gavin Lux up. Lux 0-3. Makes that 0-4 with a strikeout. Getting some confidence right there. So it seems like Mick Abel is definitely that new Vince Velasquez. But Aaron Judge strikes out right there. So back-to-back punch at the end of the inning. But there was a home run. Dell Betances now for the Dodgers. Former Mets Yankees closer relief pitcher. In 22 games, he's 2-4, 19 has pitched a 5.12 ERA, so he's definitely fallen off in his career from his time with the better of the two New York teams, as JT puts that one on the ground. Third baseman fires over in time for out number one, as the Phillies are trying to just get some insurance runs right here. Bryce Harper tees off on that low middle fastball. center fielder at the wall, and no catching that one as that one clears the wall. That's going to be the second home run of the game for Bryce Harper, 17th on the season for that Phillies legend, Bryce Harper. You love to see that right there as he trots the bases slowly. Philadelphia fans on their feet cheering in their Bryce Harper jerseys. Absolutely love to see that stuff happening right here. Harper, who has become a sort of a living legend here in Philadelphia, you know, signed over up 7 years ago, I think now. We're currently in this series from the Washington Nationals. You know, came on a 13-year deal. Love to see that. But big strikeout right there for Betances, as now it's two outs in the inning for Alec Bohm, who strikes out to end the inning. So back-to-back strikeouts of Hoskins and Bohm end the inning for Dylan Betances. Able to take it on Solaire, who sends that one to left field. It's going to be a base hit, a double probably at least. Big throw by Austin Meadows, not in time. They're saying he got his hand in before the tag. In the replay, not quite decisive on where his hand did touch. Ryan O'Hearn in, and O'Hearn puts the O'Hearn on that ball. Two-run shot right there, as Nick Abel allows his second home run of the game. Hate to see that right there. It's definitely not what you expected when the flame-throwing Ray came in. I think he's got some growing pains to deal with here as he transitions from AAA ball to Major League ball. But he kind of wish he had that a little more figured out. Connor Joe in up now, and Joe goes down that changeup. Like to see that right there. And we have ourselves a pinch hitter right now. That's going to be Cody Hosey, the Aaron Nola postseason killer, coming in for a pinch hit opportunity with one out. Hosey will strike out that high, four-seam fastball, 99 on the gun. And up is Will Smith for the final out, and Will Smith goes down. So a two-run home run in the inning, but a bunch of strikeouts for Nick Abel. You'll love to see that right there. Severino gets himself the win. Mick Abel makes it dicey, lost two home runs. Couple home runs for Bryce Harper. Reese Hoskins had himself a home run, if I do remember correctly. I'm not actually sure if he had himself a home run. I think he did. He did. Hoskins definitely had a home run. But definitely a big game here for Philadelphia. Especially defeating the Los Angeles Dodgers, that perennial playoff thorn in Philadelphia's side. Running them every year. So it's always good to beat on them early. You know, just show them who means business when it comes to facing off head to head right there. But Harper played the game, two home runs, three RBI, six innings pitched, three hits, 11 strikeouts, two earned runs for Severino in the win. 2 2/3 innings pitched, nine hits, one strikeout, seven earned runs, no walks for May in the loss. Buntex on YouTube though, peace out. Rock on, stay super classy. And if you're a Braves fan, Alec Bohm got called safe. There's nothing's gonna change it. Just saying, he's safe.